So Epilepsy Board is the last step for you to be the Jedi Master of Epilepsy. This happens every 2 years. So if you did 1 year of epilepsy training or 2 years of epilepsy fellowship, you will sit for this exam. For you not to miss this opportunity, I put together the best tips and tools to master the ABPN Epilepsy Board exam. Well, the good news is that this exam is a straightforward exam, and the passing rate for the epilepsy board exam is 93%. So these are all reassuring statistics. This happens every 2 years, so you make sure you register early in your fellowship or the year after if it is not available during that year. And you will need an ACGME accredited epilepsy fellowship to do the exam now. It used to be that clinical neurophysiology fellowship can sit for the epilepsy board and grandfathering, but not anymore. And here are the best three tips for you to prepare for the exam. Tip number one is that when is the best time for you to study for the board exam? Well, it is advised that you start studying early by reading textbooks and strengthening your knowledge in epilepsy early on during the fellowship. That is better than cramming everything in the last few weeks just before the exam. Tip number two is that you need to have a strong background and foundations in epilepsy, and it is recommended that you study those topics by reviewing a textbook on epilepsy during your fellowship. And there is a great resource from the American Epilepsy Society, AES. It's called Fellows Curriculum, and it has lots of courses that review all aspects of epilepsy, and I will link those courses in the description for you to follow. Please let me know down in the comment what are the resources and tools that you use to prepare for the epilepsy board exam, so for others to benefit as well. And tip number three is, what are the books that you can study for your board exam? Well, the first book is Epilepsy Board Exam, A Comprehensive Review. This book is written by an author by Dr. Mohamad Koubeissi and Dr. Nabil Azar. This is a good book that has a diversity of authors. So it is authored by so many authors and experts in the field of epilepsy, which is a good plus. You know, it sometimes provide different styles of writing and narration, but the editors made sure that it is all coherent and did a good job with that. And this book is split in 5 parts. And every part will review multiple chapters and do narration of the information. And at the end of each part, there are multiple choice questions to assess your knowledge and review the material well. And one of the big advantages of this book, that they dove deep in epilepsy surgery aspects, and they reviewed like neuropsychological examinations, magnetoencephalogram, and advancement in neuromodulation. So that was a new addition in this book. So this book does not have an app or online subscription. However, you can buy a Kindle version, which is an online PDF version that you can review anywhere. I personally like to have an electronic version of any book when I read, so that I can study it anywhere I am. And one point that I should mention is that there are some typos and mistakes in this book, which is expected in the first edition of any book. And I think and I hope that this will be corrected in the second edition. And I did talk to the authors, and they mentioned that they will release the second edition soon, so stay tuned for that. And also stay tuned for the exclusive interviews with the authors of those books. And the second book for Epilepsy Board Review is Epilepsy Board Review by Dr. Pradeep Modur and his colleagues. This book is a smaller size book. It is comprehensive, follows the question and answer format. It does have 4 parts, and every part discuss a major subject in epilepsy, and will go over multiple questions and then answers for that. So you will not find like one specific chapter or subject, but everything is under a big umbrella under 4 subjects. And it does have online subscription, so an app, so you can access the book anywhere, anytime you want, which is a good plus for that. This book also, because it's a first edition, it does have some mistakes, but every answer was referenced for a reference, which is a really good and shows the hard work that the author did when they authored this book. And it does have plenty of illustrations and pictures for you to associate the easy patterns, the imaging, and all of that when you are studying. All right. So those 2 books were authored and released in 2017, and lots of things happened from then till now. So it is highly advised for you to get up to date on the new information, and especially in the field of neuromodulation, which is rapidly improving, and the anti-epileptic drugs. So I recommend that you review articles, continuum epilepsy, and up to date. They all have an updated information, and also the fellows curriculum is updated, and of course the American Epilepsy Society meeting is always updating us on the latest and greatest information. So now we have two books, and for you to decide, you can decide on one or another, or like I did, I got those two books and got the best out of both of them. And to learn more about other neurology board exams like the ABPN Neurology and Clinical Neurophysiology boards, and for exclusive interviews with the authors, please review these videos, and see you in the next one.